back to the character and just increase the point size. Take the direct selection tool, and here's where you have this red highlight that gives you the center point of that text. So that makes it relatively easy to increase the point size. So in order to do the scholarship, I'm just going to go to Edit Copy. And while this is still selected, I'm just going to go to Object and Lock Selection, just so it stays there. And go to Edit, Paste in Place, puts it exactly on top of it. Take the text tool and just select it all, and now just put scholarship. Take the direct selection tool and see if I can't rotate this around and come all the way down to the bottom and just invert it so it goes over to the top. And then in the character palette down at the bottom has the offset. So I'll stretch it out there. And then the part that has the tracking and the kerning, just decrease that a little bit so it'll fit. Minus 100, so that makes it a little bit easier for that section. And then take the text tool in the type section and just type in North Olmsted. Select it all, come back, you have to change the tracking back to 0. Place that right into there. Zoom in a little bit. You can see it's just a little bit smaller, so just click inside the point size, and you can see that the N and the O are a little bit larger. So let's see if it's going to do it here. Okay, so text tool. Highlight this, it'll actually tell you what point size to make it. There you have that. So you have all of the text and the circle graphics. The only thing you need next is the N and this banner and the book. So I'm just going to hide most of that just temporarily. And take the pen tool. Put it on a new layer and go ahead and illustrate this out. Let's reset this so it's fill the stroke. You can make it a straight box, that's fine. Gives you the center line right there. Temporarily just take off the fill. Go ahead and deselect and go ahead and draw this part out. So these two pieces have a white backing to it. Take the reflect tool, just hold the option right on the center line, preview it, and copy it over there so you have it stretched across. And just take the rectangle tool, right from the center, stretch this out. That gives you the beginning of that section. Option if you need to adjust it symmetrically for that part. Okay. So we're just going to select this right here and hide that selection. And just take a look at the book. This is here. Do the pen tool again. just making one page of this. Drop it down. Option, bring it up a little bit. Select the both of them. The reflect tool. Here's the book in the back. Group it together. And the last part is the letter N. And you can do it two ways. You can draw it from scratch, or you can actually take the letter from the text and make your own letter. Let's see, if you go under Impact, it's a good basic bold font. Lines to it. Stretch it out. Use a stroke. So you can use the beginning of it, or you can draw it from scratch right away. If you do the type, you just have to create outlines and use the direct selection tool to adjust these points. So I'm just selecting both of them. Move that over. So here it has the outline of the text. That gives you the stroke, and then once you have it, just go to Object Path, offset the path, and click OK, go to Object Show All, bring it all back. There you have the path. It's just a matter of going through and highlighting the different pieces and bringing them forward to put them under the shapes.